everyone, thanks for watching. Today I'm doing a little bit of a different video. I am doing an unboxing video. I recently ordered an airbrush and I asked around if anyone would like to see me unbox and show the contents of my order, and it was an astounding yes. And yes, I do have a little friend joining me today. He's probably going to annoy the crap out of me, but it's the only way I can keep him quiet to film during the day. So let's do this. I got the Dinair Airbrush and it comes in a great big box like this. And I'm just going to cover there because apparently my address is there. And it has these fragile stickers all over it, but it looks like it's been used as a football. And as I found out when I picked it up as well, that customs have actually opened this already. So it'll be interesting to see if there's any damages. So let's get to it and let's unbox this. So I have scissors because I haven't even opened it yet myself, which is just me, has been hard to do because I just want to get in and use it. Oh, let's cut through here. Sorry, this is off camera. It's too hard to sort of readjust it all the time. So let's just cut it open and then I'll show you what's inside the box. Because customs have opened it from the bottom. And the bird wants in. Okay. Out of the way. Inspection. Assholes, stay out of my shit. Okay, so at least no items have been removed, so that's good. So that was just sitting on top. What do we got? I'll just hold it up. And it's just got all the paperwork and stuff on top, so I'll take that out. We've got the exchanges and returns. Read that later. I don't think I'll need to exchange or return anything. Oh, look at that. They gave me some little $5 off on next purchase and free makeup with kit purchase. Oh, I've already purchased a kit, so that's probably not going to come in handy. But maybe I can give that to someone. Might be able to give that to someone, so we'll see if anyone I know wants to buy an airbrush. Okay. Use a pin to make a small hole in the seal. There's going to be some loud noises because where he's climbing is going to end very badly shortly. Come on. Not for bird. Okay, so that just tells you how to open the little things. And they've given you some sample face charts, I think. Oh, yes. Yay! Aha! So they've given you some examples on how to do it, which is awesome. They've given you a little face chart. And then, oh, again, how to control it and what it should look like. So that's pretty cool. Ooh, now we get into the exciting stuff. Bird, come here. So this is inside. I guess this is all my kit and all my makeup is over here as well. So let's pull that one out. Oh, that's nice. They give you a nice little bag for it all to go in. Oh dear. One has leaked. God damn it. Okay, so one's leaked. I'll have a look at that in a sec. Get everything out. Okay. Alright, so there's the little box. And let's see if I can do this without it falling off. And there's my airbrush. And I got the white because everything in my room is white. So that's cool. And Okay, so they're just air packets, so we can get rid of that. Yes, little man. Yes. Okay. So first I'm going to go through the colours and what I got. I tried to get a range of lights and darks and all sorts of things. And oh, okay. This is strange. One would expect that to zip around, but it doesn't. So it's only got a really small opening. Okay, so let's have a look. Airbrush cleaner. Okay, these are my little foundations that I ordered. I might do a video with swatches of these. I tried to get, sort of, as you can see, I tried to get a really broad range and a range that I could mix as well, so that I, you know, it was really hard to choose them. What else have we got? Oh, my airbrush hose. Hey, Noisy. I know. You want them. What is this? Oh. This must be a sample, because I don't remember ordering these. Okay, so this is a little corrective. It's olive beige corrective, so concealer. What is this one? Oh, face tanner, so I could tan up my face if I wanted to, and judging, I need to. What else have we got? Oh, this is the one that leaked. Look how leaky. I don't know if you can see that, but look how leaky it is. I'm really annoyed at that. Hey! Is Mama making noises? Shh. Okay, so I'll pull those out in a minute. I'm just going to finish going through these. The spaces and things for cleaning. And the practice colour and the moist and dewy. Oh my god, look how tiny that moist and dewy is. That's kind of annoying, because I know I'm probably going to use that a fair bit, being having really dry skin, so I'll be using that on myself a fair bit. Alright, what, one last thing in here and then we'll go through all the stencils. So, oh, just a little bottle to do your water with. So that's cool. I'd actually already saved a little drip bottle, but this will be better because now I don't have to wash out the other one. All right, so that's them. And let's go through the stencils and then I'll open up the colors and have a look at how badly that one leaked. All right, so the rest of what is in that bag, I just took it out. I'll show you. Little bag. It'll come in handy to keep everything together when I'm moving. Is that scaring you? Sorry. Shh. Quiet birdies. Okay, so there's the spacer that you use. You hook onto your airbrush when you're learning so that you know how far away to use it. So I'll stick that over with the airbrush. And a little case to put the gun in. Alright. Ooh, eyeliner stencils. Yes. Yes, can I help you? So, I don't know how well these are gonna actually show up. So these are the little eyeliner stencils. They've got the full length ones and the little wing. I will open these up, see if I can show them a little bit better. Hey, Noisy. Hey, Noisy. Okay, so there's two here. Let's see if I can... It's okay. Show that... Actually, clear might be better. So you can see they're the full length for doing winged eyeliner. And then this one is just the little tips. So if you want like a big fat wing, and it goes right down to the small ones. The shadow shield, I'll open it. Hey! take that tone of voice at me, young man. You. Yes. Okay, so just your shadow shield for doing under your eyes. Sorry, I've got my glasses on, so that was probably a bad idea. But these are for like the edges of your eyes and underneath and stuff. All fairly standard. Anyone who has seen these knows what they are. Let's see what else we've got. Eyebrow stencils. Oh, it didn't come with the one I was hoping it would. Bugger. They have this one and it's like eyebrow hairs, and I was really looking forward to that. But it's just a big sheet and I'll probably, oh yeah, they come apart. Just so you can do your eyebrows, depending on, oh my god, what shape of eyebrow you have, I suppose. That's a very rounded eyebrow. Now, I've got my warranty card. Oh gosh. Wow. So like a stencil catalog here, and it just shows all of the stencils that they have, which is incredible. Oh, they have pony ones. Yes, little man. So I guess that's, oh, I'm so annoyed they didn't do the, oh, and just a color card for all of their different things. Okay, so warranty, quick start guide, and the instructional DVD. Let's put those aside. And I'll put my cards aside. Okay, let's open this up and see what we can do. I might need, let's grab some tissues so that I can clean it up. This is why, when things have fragile on them, the post office shouldn't use them as a football, which is pretty much what my packet looks like it's happened. Right. Let's get all of these out so that I can clean up these last two. And then I will show you the colours. So I'll go through all the colours that I got. I'll go through the foundations first. Now, I did get the Colaire foundations, so they have a number on them. But what I'll do is, in the box down below, I'll actually put what shade that is closest to. It's listed on their website, but I'll put down below what shade it's closest to. I know a couple of them off the top of my head because, hey, like the lightest and the darkest ones. So first of all, I got, I believe, okay, so this is C103, which I believe is vanilla, which is their lightest shade. Either vanilla or alabaster. I think vanilla is their lightest shade. So that's probably gonna be me. I might mix a little bit of the alabaster in for myself. So there's C103. And then the next one, I'm just going to shake them up so you get a look at what their real colours are. So, actually this one might be closer to me. C117, which I believe is the alabaster. And now the next ones, I have no idea. But I got C128, so sort of a tan, golden tan, medium tan, or a maybe even a lightish tan. It's very warm toned. And then the next one is C133. I don't know if you can see those. Am I holding them up okay? I hope so. We'll see when I try to edit. And the next one is like super dark, which is, and there's an even darker one coming, but C151. So I wanted a red toned dark, so if, I don't know, for things like Indian ladies, things like that, that have the more reddish undertones and the darker skin. So I wanted to be fairly broad. And then the next one is C172, which I believe is closest to cocoa. This one, I'll probably use to darken up shades, things like that, or even as eyeshadow. So they're the foundations I got. I got 6 to start off with because, I don't know, it was so hard to choose. It was so hard to choose. You got to choose 16 shades from their range with the kit that I got, and I wanted to do some really basic stuff outside of foundation as well. So things like, I got the blonde. Yeah, that's, which is all, yeah, it's all like separated and there is just, there is not much left in there. So the blonde was for eyebrows, of course. I got jet black for obvious purposes, eyeliner, even adding into browns and stuff to darken things up for eyebrows. I will probably have to add that to a brown to get an eyebrow shade for me. I got a opal white shimmer for highlighting, etc. Birdie, why are you being so vocal? I also got a that one took a while to move, a champagne shimmer as well. So highlighter for on darker skins. And yes, in case you're wondering, he did just poop on me. Okay, and then I got a few of the, what are they, what do they call them? I think they call them neutralizers. Yes, neutralizers. I got the light yellow and the light green for covering red spots, things like that. We'll see. Then I got some blushes. It's because of the shaking, he's gonna be noisy. If I stop making noise, he stops making noise. You just want attention, don't you? No. Okay, rejected. So I got cloudy pink for blushes. I got bronze rose for blush so that I had something a bit darker, and I got soft pink as well. So I kind of wanted to go really soft, medium and dark, and I didn't want to keep them all super pink, which is why I got the bronze rose as well, so it had a little bit of a bronzy glow to it. And then last of all, I got fawn brown, which was in the eyebrow and area. And I think it's probably, it's certainly not going to be an eyebrow color. So I think that's just gonna be an eyeshadow or something. We live and learn. So yeah, that's it. Other than the tan, which I haven't even taken out, I probably won't use that very much, to be honest. They give you a practice shade. So let's have a look at what's in here. So there's my little moist and dewy. Just tiny. It's so itty bitty. And my practice colour. It just says practice colour. So you can see, I don't know. I don't really know what else to say. I'll probably give, oh, whoops. I'm dropping things. I'm scaring the bird. I'll probably give a better review when I actually swatch them and test them out. I'm thinking of doing a video of me using it for the very first time, so that will be really interesting if I do that. So yeah, I think that's it. Is that it? Is Harvey gonna say goodbye? This is Harvey, by the way. I kind of forgot to mention that. Harvey is not a touching bird, as you can see. He does not like to be touched. Breaks my heart. So I think, oh, maybe I should grab the gun out and stuff and show you that. I guess that would be an idea. So, oh, it's all like taped in. Okay, so there's that. It's got the little stand or little cup to sit it in on the side. This is so much smaller than I imagined it would be. I would have thought it would be like, you know, maybe half this size again. It's actually really, really tiny. So, oh, it's got a little diamante on it. That's cute. So there's that, and the little air hose goes in the back there. Oh, 30! What's the matter? And this guy, oh my god. They've like really, really stuck him on there. And there's the little gun. So, oh. First time moving it was a bit hard. It's got those less is more guides, so that's cool. It's pretty lightweight. I think it'll be easier to sort of move and adjust once it has air flowing through it and a bit of pressure. But there's the needle. Sorry. Look, it's very pretty. It's very nice. Not that I think that would really matter, but it'll be interesting to play with. So let's sit him in there. And then it just comes with the power pack. So that's it, I think. That's it, I guess. Yeah, stick around. I will do some more videos on this. I'll do some swatches and I will do a hey, watch me fail at this for my very first time video as well. So, thanks for watching. Thumbs up, share, ask in the comments if you want me to do anything. And yeah, I'll see you around.